12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And on this week's show, we've got some great releases, actually. It's been a very good month for Magic. Sorry we missed out on the Wizard Product Review last week. Both myself and Sean were on family holidays and Wayne didn't fancy doing it by himself. And now Wayne's taking a break today.
That's it.
So he's on break. And we've got some great releases. But we normally like think about, do we have something to talk about that's kind of in the news or something like that, and chat about what's going on. We can't really go without mentioning the loss of Anthony Owen to the Magic community. And Anthony was friends of myself and Sean, not just in the Magic industry, but growing up as kids.
Yeah. I mean, if you knew Anthony a lot better than me.
Yeah.
I've always, since a kid and since living in Northampton, I've always known Anthony and his relationship with the Magic clubs and everything. And he's one of the guys that came from the area. They did incredibly big things for Magic.
Yeah, so if you watch the show abroad, you probably can't kind of get a grasp on it, but myself and Sean live in an area called Northamptonshire.
Yeah.
And our local Magic club, the Northamptonshire Magicians Club, where they actually honoured Anthony recently after his contribution to the Magic community and made him a life president. But we grew up, and I was trying to think about it the other night, and me and Anthony have known each other since we were about 13. And before Anthony moved to London and made huge waves in the Magic community, like most young magicians, we lived a little bit further apart, but his parents, or he used to come on the train, used to bring him to my house 1 week,
yeah,
and then I'd go to his house the next week, and we used to save our pocket money and buy a very expensive rate, you know, the latest Ron McMillan International Magic VHS tape. And we're going back quite some time. I can still remember today having a phone call with him on like a Sunday night where he said, it's a good one this time. And I've watched one trick, but I'll save the rest till you get there. And it was the first time we watched David Williamson.
Wow.
So, you know, that was a great memory. The first time I ever saw David Williamson perform was I sat down with Anthony and we went and like press play, you know, on this huge clunky machine and saw all this incredible material. And then, of course, Anthony started writing his Dungeon magazine, moved to London, joined Dynamic Effects, and then went on to influence and work behind the scenes on some of the biggest TV shows of the last 20 years. Mm. And strange atmosphere at the Magic Circle last night, a lot of people talking about Anthony, and he'll be a sad loss to the Magic community. Maybe not amongst hobbyists, people won't know him, but certainly professionals and people that know him from the TV industry will miss Anthony Owen. The first product up for review this week is Venom Cube. It's available from rubiksdream.com and it's by Mr. Magic Rubik Cube inventor Henry Harrius. He's had a lot of products come out.
Rubble.
Obviously, Rubik's Dream, Cube to Chocolate. Like, this guy's pretty much done it all, and this is his version now. He's tackled one of the most intriguing plots in Cube Magic, which is the Cube Matching Effect.
Well, I think it's the strongest plot for me to watch as a non-Rubik's Cube performer. I think it's the strongest plot in Cube Magic.
It's interesting. As you know, this is a trick that I've done for quite a while now. Not with a Venom Cube, but more about that very shortly.
Yeah.
And I do find that an intelligent audience really does respond to it really well, because it is so impossible.
Well, what's great about it in the effect-wise, if you're doing a solve, it's like, okay, he's going to try and solve the cube, however it gets solved.
Yeah.
Now this, so if you're conditioning them into the routine that the cube keeps getting solved, this then takes a left turn, because they go, oh, he's going to solve it now. Then all of a sudden, it doesn't get solved. And there's kind of that, is it right? Is it wrong? What's happened? And then you bring in, bam, slap them around the face and go, you already solved it.
We are going to share some footage in a moment. So I did go, we're reviewing this, and I'm reviewing it from a personal experience of going out and trying this and getting an incredible reaction. And not only getting an incredible reaction, whilst performing it, feeling so clean and open and fair, which when I've used methods in the past, like Rubicon was not as good as Perfect Square. Perfect Square was certainly a step forward. It meant that in full view, you could do this move, but there was always a little bit of nervousness when I did the move. And it's probably the reason, actually, that I started using a business card in my presentation. Because I gave a business card to somebody and said, on the back of that business card, there's some numbers, there's a prediction. And then I would get different people to pick a number between 1 and 10, and they would mix the cube that many times. So we can show you what this looks like. Do you want to mix that cube, Sean? And I'll leave this cube just here, like a spare cube. And obviously, when you're performing it, you'll see some footage of a wedding in a moment. But a cube is mixed by three different members of the audience. Then I used to say, I've made a prediction. Take the cube back. I've made a prediction. Turn over the business card. And when they turned over the business card, with the Rubik, with the perfect square rather, I would do the move at that point. Here's how clean it is with the Venom cube, and it's unbelievable. They read out the number, which in my case is 1,589 quintillion. Mm-hmm. And I explain that that is the odds. That is the odds that one side on these cubes actually matches, which it does perfectly. Not only that, side 2 actually matches perfectly. Side 3 and side 4, in fact, all 5 sides match perfectly. And in my opinion, it can't get any cleaner than that.
It can't,
that.
It's incredible. I'm sitting here watching it as well. I'm like going, wow, it's great.
It looks absolutely incredible. And obviously you need to say as well, because for review purposes, that when, even though the cubes have been mixed and even though they match because of the genius of this routine, the way that it's structured, you're now left in your favourite cube situation, let's just call it. So, you know, Blammo, for example, he's learned how to solve a cube. He looks for blocks of colour, he blows on the cube, and when he blows, the blue starts to solve itself. He blows again, and the orange starts to solve itself, and the green. If you watch the red solves, and then eventually all 6 sides of the Rubik cube are completely solved. Thank you
very
much.
David Penn, everybody.
Thank you very much. And I like it that during the routine, the first thing I start with, just for completeness, I mix the cube, explaining how many times a cube is away from being solved, and explain that it's 20 moves away from being solved. You mix it 20 times, explain the world record's 4 seconds, how many times would you have to twist a cube every single second to be able to solve it. And then from there you go straight on to handing out this cube to be mixed, and it ends up perfectly matched with the Venom cube.
It's great.
It's unbelievable. The tutorial you get with it is about an hour.
Yeah.
You also get taught Henry's recurring nightmare solve, which is an incredible visual solve.
Oh, man. Yeah.
And then a new solve from the cube legend Akira himself, the gear solve, which you loved, didn't you, when you saw this? He literally just goes, vroom,
and
it's solved in front of you. Looks absolutely incredible. They're bonuses on the tutorial. But the Venom cube, basically, is the best, the definitive version, as far as I'm concerned, of the cube matching effect.
Yeah, I agree.
If you want to do the cube matching and you want to give a Rubik cube routine that you do some real substance and do something which is absolutely against the odds, totally impossible, then the only way to do it is with Venom cube. I've been out, I've done it. Footage, we'll put it on the screen, everybody watching at the one time that I did this. And that's because this type of effect plays so big. It's a huge effect. Even though I was doing it for the bride and groom that were right here, there were people in the room at the tables, people stood around, and everybody watching it. And you can see the reaction on people's faces when just the first side matches. there's a girl, and you can actually see her go, oh my goodness, there's no way that can happen. What I love about the cube matching effect as a performer, and we talk about this a lot on the Wizard Product Review, is the energy you can get into it. Because you go, one, two, three, five, six, all six sides, and you're showing it and you're building the energy before you go into an incredible visual solve as a finale. Look, if you want to do the cube matching, I've been out, I've used it, I've seen the reactions. I felt how much better it is to use than every other version that's on the market. You've got to get the Venom Cube. It's available from rubiksdream.com. I think it's $155.
Yeah, for when, what it is, it's nothing.
When this effect came out, to start with, the first version of it, I know people like Darren Brown had done it in his stage show, but when the first version actually came out commercially, you know, it was a lot more money.
Yeah.
And for the price, for the effect, it really is worth it. I can't give this less than 100%, Sean. It's fantastic. It's something that I'm going to do forever now.
Yeah.
I've always loved this routine that I've done. I've enjoyed performing it. But I think sometimes as a professional, if you can look at things that you do and make them 5% better, 10%
better, what you should do.
You've got to invest in it. You've got to make it better. And Venom Cube, it's the next step. And it's the biggest step in the cube matching effect. How much are you going
to
give it?
I have to give it 100%. I have to, because I know I'm going to do that at some point. At some point it's going to get done by me. And it's not just that. That would mean I have to give it more than 90%. But it's that good. It is so good. Once you've learned the secret to this, it's just incredible.
And the setup, just to be complete, you know, the tutorial's about an hour. You've got a one-time setup that takes about 20 minutes. Yeah. And then once you do that, it's so easy.
It's
to do the effect.
You'll be guilty.
Yeah.
You'll be feeling guilty going, oh my God, everybody's clapping and it's just, I'm doing
nothing. Yeah, it's just so easy compared to most magic. And yet the effect is huge.
Yeah.
Last time we had a competition on the Wizard Product Review to win Chop Glass by Alan Hudson. If you haven't seen this, get over to worldmagicshop.com and check out one of the most organic versions of the Chop Cup you will ever see, where you turn a glass on the table into a Chop Cup. And it's got lots of other features as well. It looks amazing when you produce the loads at the end. Certainly a hit of Blackpool last year. And the winner of the competition was
Mr. Max Gibson.
Max Gibson.
Not Max.
Everybody commented about Foolers, wasn't it? Or commented on the show, but a lot of people debating whether Foolers was good for magic or bad for magic. Max put a comment on the YouTube channel, and he was pretty much in favour. He thought it was a show that made people respect the art of magic. So, Max, you've got Chop Glass on the way to you. Congratulations to our competition winner. Right, we turn the smoke alarm off. Blammo's back on the sofa.
Take two.
We are ready for take two of Light It Up.
I think it might have been my fault a little bit.
And Light It Up is kind of like a Zippo lighter. It's from the SansMinds Creative Lab, and it's from their Pro Series. And SansMinds Magic do bring out, every now and then, some really good quality bits of kit.
It's brilliant.
And one of my favourite things they brought out, I think they're hard to come by now, is the Vanishing Ring Box.
Yep.
And I can see this being another item like that. One of those items that's only available for like a certain amount of time. And then, you know, people are trying to get hold of them. And as with the Vanishing Ring Box, you're always seeing like ads on secondhand sites going, wanted, I need a Vanishing Ring Box, because they're not available anymore. Light Me Up is one of their latest additions to the Pro Series. This is the black version. They've got three different colour schemes, like a maroon one and like a leather looking one. And it's a Zippo lighter that lights under remote.
Yeah.
So, not a trick in itself.
I'd say it's a utility device.
It doesn't work with
it's
remote.
It's not by remote. It lights itself. So you open it up,
magic.
You put it down on the table. You wait a few seconds. You're in control of how long, whether it may be 5 seconds or 10 seconds. You're in control of that. After the amount of time that you wish, it then lights. Now, whilst it's not, I'd say, a magical effect in itself, what it will is make your magic look more magical.
Yeah.
So if you wanted to produce coins from the flame, or do something with flash paper, and what it allows you to do is, rather than having to hold a lighter, like this with one hand, it then brings both of your hands into play. So if you wanted to steal extra loads, or do anything naughty, you know, one hand does, the other wants the other hand to do something sneaky, it allows you to do that and free up your hands. And it also adds that magical bit where you put it down on the table and then it starts as a misdirection for you to take in whatever.
Yeah.
And then you're going into whatever you do.
And, you know, as they show on the trailers, a great deck vanish. I think it's a move of Chad Long's that I've used in presentations before, where you show a piece of flash paper, throw it to your hand, and then as you throw it to your hand, the flash turns into the object in your hand.
Okay.
That's a really cool move. To produce a small object in your empty hand as well, but from a flash. But you always need to use either a candle or somebody holding a lighter. These guys that are out there, you know, producing ice, you have to light something to start with. This is something that could make that more impactful as a routine. The gimmick's very, very good. I know I said remote, but like Sean clarified, it's not remote. It works by itself and it's all internal. Charges up very, very quickly, works all very, very well itself. It's a very clever little bit of kit. And I know they were selling a lot of them at Blackpool. A lot of people bought it, like Venom Cube. It's one of those things that right now it's on the market. It's just come to the market and everybody's starting to get them. It's a nice little piece of kit.
Yeah.
And that's probably why they call it their Pro Series. And I'm actually very, very impressed with this gimmick. Personally, I don't have a use for it right now. I do use a lighter in my close-up set, but it has to be around here that I light something for, because it's to do with another trick. I have to light it stood up here, so I can't do it while the object's on the table. So I don't have a use for it right now, but I'm very, very impressed with the quality of this apparatus. I'm going to give this 91%.
Yeah, I'm going to do it. I know it's not going to go into any of my routines. It is going to get used for me by me at some point. I'm going to give it 92% as well. Yeah, very good.
Our final review this week is DARYL's Ultimate Ambition. So DARYL had this is a finale to his FISM award-winning routine. It's a re-release. It's kind of like Ultimate Ambition Improved.
Well, the original was called Ultimate Ambition Improved.
Oh, was it? Right, okay.
That's the name of it. Yeah,
I thought the improvement was the bit that Greg Wilson has added to it, but more about that shortly. I wanted to show that because I've had a couple of these on my shelf for a while, my magic shelf, because this is something that I've used for quite some time. It's been unavailable, but this was the original when you used to buy them from DARYL.
From the Fool of Doolers
range. Murphy's Magic are continuing that mantra. And any Murphy's Magic dealer now is now supplying the DARYL range. You can get the Enchanted Cube and a few other things. But the Ultimate Ambition Improved with this very, very devious gimmick.
So
it's unbelievably good. Anybody that knows what it is knows how clever the gimmick is. We don't want to say too much about it. Also comes with a piece of rope. Personally, I don't use this piece of rope. I don't like it. I don't think it behaves as well as a nice thick piece of magician's rope. But the gimmick itself
is brilliant.
It's absolutely unbelievable. I'm sure this rope's all right, sufficient, but I don't think it's good enough for the effect, and I'll kind of show you why and explain in a moment, but certainly good enough to practice with, but you might want something a bit more substantial.
If you're doing a professional gig, you want a piece of rope that looks really like a piece of rope.
I think so. And being a bit longer, I think gives you that ability to kind of present it a bit more like an illusion.
Yeah.
And as we said earlier about the journey that people go on when they're doing this routine. Like, you do Ambitious Card, sure.
I do Ambitious Card.
Why do you do Ambitious Card?
Well, I do Ambitious Card because, well, I learned it when I was a kid, and then it's turned into this whole piece of jazz magic now, hasn't it?
Yeah.
It lasts about 10 minutes long, and the cards everywhere, and this and that and the other. Very fast-paced thing. Now, what I've never done, which is produce a card from the wallet at the end.
Yeah.
And the reason for that is, so many times I'm at gigs, especially at corporate events where they're used to having entertainment, and they go, oh yeah, we had a magician last year, and at the end, he pulled the card out of his wallet. Well, I don't want to be lumped in with all of them other magicians. I want my magic to be unique.
Yeah.
And that is one of the reasons why, at the end of my ambitious card routine, I do this. Because I think it's stronger than the card coming out of the wallet. It's more in theme with the ambitious card. You've been making the card jump to the deck in more and more possible ways. So why would it end up inside your wallet?
We have to review it. We have to show you these things. But this is something that I've closed on at tables. Mm. This is something that you've closed on. And the reason is it actually feels like an illusion. Because if you perform the ambitious card, you're doing it each time. And then as I explain to the spectators, just like DARYL did, but I have another line of patter that I use, but DARYL used to say it can only be done one of two ways. It's either magic or it's sleight of hand.
Yeah.
So one way I can prove to you that this isn't sleight of hand is to sleight of hand proof the deck. I go a little bit further because I say the only way to do this trick, if a card goes into the middle of the deck, you have to cut the deck of cards, bringing the bottom half and that card to the top of the deck, and then you can show that it's now on the top. That's the only way to do it. But you can't do that if you sleight of hand proof a deck of cards. And it is great to be able to wrap up a deck of cards in front of them and sleight of hand proof the deck. It is absolutely unbelievable. And if you wrap a deck with rope like that, it's absolutely impossible to do sleight of hand, and you can display it like this. It's crazy. You can then take a signed card.
Here's one I prepared earlier. Yeah, and it really, even though we prepared it early just for speed, this is genuine. I don't know why we did that. This is a signed card. It's not like there's multiple versions of this, but that's my signature on the card.
And look, that really does go into the middle of the deck. And you can show this, and it's so fair.
You can take it up to the camera.
Yeah.
You can go and have a look. That really is in the middle of the pack. You can see the face of the card as well.
Yeah.
They can check it's the card. You can keep teasing them and then showing that it really is the card going in. You can even let them tap it some of the way in. You can, you know, it really does go into the middle of all the cards.
It cannot be any fairer than this. As that card, can you see that on the camera, goes right into the middle of the deck. And it really is in the middle of the deck. And the deck is wrapped with rope. You can't possibly do sleight of hand at all. You can't do anything, but as I do when I'm performing, you still have to do the move. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And then they're looking, they're expecting it. But really, right on the top of the deck, and I always have them sign the card. So as soon as you bring that up, they can see the signature. You can pull it out a bit, drop it down, and then show that it's genuinely on the top of the deck. And you have done it in literally impossible conditions.
And it's so impossible that the people that are a little bit newer to magic would appreciate this. DARYL won FISM. With this trick.
He blew magicians away with it.
Magicians were going, no, it was in the... But they couldn't get it.
Yeah.
It just happened.
Like me, the first time I saw him doing it, that cannot work. There's no way that can happen. And it really is that incredible. It's a great closer. The gimmick is first class. I think you need a better piece of rope, like I said, but everything you get with it for the price will take your ambitious card routine to the next level, and you can close on it. Like Sean said, I've closed on it. It really is a fantastic, totally impossible piece of magic.
Well, yeah, now there are some extra features on the DVD. Because what I think you're buying, what you're getting for your money, is the gimmick and is the advice from DARYL.
Yeah.
What's also on there is like a bonus extra feature, if you like, is some modern, like some more advice from Greg Wilson.
Well, Greg, for example, we talked about this earlier, and we both said, well, I don't kind of agree with that.
No.
There were a couple of the things. Greg, it's a clever idea, and I think some people might look at it, which is to eliminate the rope completely and to use the card box. But I don't know if it's because I'm an illusionist, but you certainly agree, but you do illusions as well. it's the fact that when you introduce the rope, there's a change of shape in the performance to the standard ambitious card, and everything becomes this illusion and impossible. And you're watching things all of a sudden.
It's just got bigger. You do the big finale of that routine, it's just got bigger and more visual, as it should have. And the other thing, I think, with the card box, is what's great about the rope is people can actually see the deck, both sides of the deck.
Yeah.
It's not completely covered, so they can actually see it. Sleight of hand proof, and they can see where the card's going to appear, and it still appears there. When it goes in the box,
which is Greg's idea,
I don't think it moves the effect any forward. I think it's kind of, you know,
Greg also says that you should have the signature in the middle, so when the card comes out, they're intrigued. I disagree with that as well, because I have personally performed this professionally for years, and people, when you go, no, really, it's happened. I think when you lift it up, they have to go, no, that is the same card at that moment, and then you're showing it, and then you're taking it out. And DARYL used to have multiple people sign the card, which is a great way to get more people involved. He even used to tear the corner off, because even if you tear the corner off, that signed card
works.
Will still go to the top of the deck, which is absolutely incredible. And it's unbelievable. Can't say enough about it. It's probably the best selection of effects we've ever had on the Wizard product review. But it won FISM. You can do it in your act now. The gimmick is first class.
It's great.
I can't say any more.
It's brilliant. If I was going to do it, do the original DARYL way. You've got the experts from Greg on there as well. I do it all the time. It's another 100% for
me. If you see me working at an event, you're going to see me doing the Venom Cube. You're going to see me doing Ultimate Ambition Improved at professional engagements. That's why it has to be 100%. From me.
From me.
Definitely from you as well. And that's it this week for the Wizard product review. Only 3 reviews this week. So like we say, we just got back off holiday. But 3 of the best reviews, 3 of the best quality products that we've had on the Wizard product review for some time. And these are all workers. And I bet you could insert them into your set. That's it. Until next time on the Wizard product review. Thank you very much for watching. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
See you next time on the Wizard Product Review.